Wildcats!
Welcome back to the 2020 second episode of Wildcat TV on Comcast 15.
I'm Aislinn Plumberg.
And I'm Sydney Wade. We know this year has been just stressful for the teachers as well as the students, and we wanted to show those teachers some gratitude.
So we decided to give a shout out to some teachers that might need it. Let's send it over to Lucian to spotlight these great teachers.
We know 2020 has been stressful on a lot of our teachers, and we just wanted to cheer you up in some sort of way. I'm here with Josh Lowy, asking him who his favorite teachers are and why.
It would either have to be Miss Yoder, because she's really funny, or my father, because he's my father, and I hang out in his room all the time.
Who's your favorite teacher and why in 10 seconds?
Probably Mr. Wilson, just because I like his class, and I'm never bored in it. It's just a fun class to learn and, you know, expand my knowledge and business.
Who's your favorite teacher and why in 10 seconds?
Miss Gilmore, because she's actually considerate and knows how to teach, and she's nice.
In 10 seconds, say your favorite teacher and why.
Miss Little Page, because she's really funny, and she's also an English teacher, and I like English too, and she's really nice.
You're out of time.
Oh.
Who's your favorite teacher and why in 10 seconds?
I would say my favorite as of right now is Mr. Cusack, because he understands when students are late if they're on the other side of the campus.
Who's your favorite teacher and why in 10 seconds?
I like Mr. Palermo because he's like really funny and he does graphic design, so he's kind of different than all the other teachers I have. So.
Who's your favorite teacher and why in 10 seconds?
My favorite teacher is Miss Kendall because she's always there for me and I can always count on her.
Who's your favorite teacher and why in 10 seconds?
Oh, my favorite teacher is Ms. Lil Page because she's awesome, she's chill.
Those were just a few choices our students picked, but we still appreciate each and every one of you. Now back to the studio.
Wow, those teachers really deserved the praise.
Yeah. Another teacher that's been going above and beyond is Morgan Payton and our team from FFA. Here are some of their accomplishments from this year.
What's up, Wildcats? I'm grateful to announce that some of our FFA members have been making some amazing accomplishments since this last spring. Like how our chapter won the Sweepstakes Award in Floriculture at the Central District Fair this past July. One of our own Wildcats named Ava Nastasio is an Area 6 FFA officer, meaning she covers about 20 other schools and ours in FFA.
They also earned a gold star in 30th place in our national application out of 500 chapters in Missouri.
At the same chapter application, they received a national level 3-star rating. They would have gone to nationals this upcoming October, but due to COVID, there is no convention. Because of this, how about we give them our own congratulations? Now, I know it's not the same, but nonetheless, you guys did great. Nice job, Wildcats.
Thanks, Bella.
Ugh.
Hey, are you okay?
No, I'm just so frustrated and stressed with homework and my phone and no money.
Hey,
and
whoa. I think you need to talk to Miss Gordon about the new anger management club.
We have an anger management club?
Yeah, along with a lot of the other clubs that you can check out. Let's go send it to Ava with more information.
Hey, Wildcats, it's Ava. You may have noticed some flyers around school promoting some new clubs. Here's Miss Gordon with more information.
So this semester we want to focus on making connections and helping you guys find a group that fits you. So we will be offering 3 groups for our students: gender sexuality, anger management, and life skills. Gender sexuality and anger management will be taught by Jessica Walker. Those groups will start on Mondays and will continue every Monday for at least 6 weeks. Life skills will be taught by Comprehensive Mental Health. Those groups start Thursday, October 1st, and will continue on every Thursday. Groups will be held during school hours, so you don't have to worry about coming before and after school. If you want to participate in our groups, please come see me in the Counseling Center for a permission slip.
Thank you, Ms. Gordon. These are all great clubs if you're looking to get involved this school year. Signing off, I'm Ava.
Wow, I feel a lot better now.
Well, I know I'll feel better after we get some Culvers, so let's go.
This is Zach at the Culvers in Blue Springs. Just wanted to welcome you all back to school and say hope to see you soon. Our drive-thru has been open during this whole time. It's actually faster than ever. We got people out there when we need to, and there's too many cars to take orders, as well as we're getting you in and out and keeping the line moving. So we got some great products in right now. We got pretzel bites, we got pumpkin, shakes, concretes, and as well as we have delicious cheese curds and butter burgers all time.
Welcome to Big Frog, where we make customized t-shirts and face masks in a safe social distancing environment. Let's get started. First, browse through our huge selection of shirts, which you can find online on our website, bigfrog.com/independence. Second, send a message to the store about what kind of shirts you're looking for, and one of our awesome designers will schedule a video chat. Third, it's off to our awesome printing machine. Then, it's the best part, the call you've been waiting for. Your shirts are ready for pickup. We are doing curbside service, and we'll bring them straight to your car. Try it today. Call Big Frog and Independence at 816-795-1115, and our website is bigfrog.com/independence.
Cat's Corner has moved to a new location right outside the Media Center. The new and improved store has t-shirts, Sherpas, and a cactus. Though there will be a limited supply of certain snacks, you can come visit the Cat's Corner 5th Hour all this week. Please be patient with our staff members in this difficult phase. Only 6 customers will be allowed in the store at a time, and a designated staff member will microwave the food you've purchased from the store. Come on down and take it easy at the Cat's Corner.
Wow, that Culver's was really good.
I know, I don't even want to move.
Well, I know some student athletes who know how to get moving. Sydney Clark is covering sports.
Hey Wildcats, it's Sydney, and I'm back with the first sports update of the season. The fall sports are in full swing, and everyone is off to an amazing start. The girls' softball team is having an amazing season so far, but they suffered 3 tough losses last week, one against our crosstown rivals. The girls fought hard in an intense game versus South. The Cats rallied back in the 7th inning, but it wasn't enough to come out on top with the win, losing 5-4. They also fell short to Lee Summit West 3-2 and Park Hill 15-14. Wish them luck as they have a full week of games. The volleyball team lost in a close 5 sets against Liberty North, but they took a whole sweep over South, 25-11, 25-16, and 25-9. Wish them luck as they have a game against Lee Summit North today. The girls' cross-country team won their meet a few weeks ago at the Tim Nix Invitational and took 4th place at the Lee Summit North Invitational. Abby Brackenberry took 3rd place, and congrats to Ayanna Foster and Ariana Jackson who placed. Wish them luck as they have a race this weekend at the Socket to Cancer Invitational. The boys' soccer team currently has a record of 6-3 with a huge win over Pembroke last week in overtime, with goals scored by Matthew Martinez and Kayan Hewens, with the bomb from Caden at the 20 that won the game. They continue their season tomorrow as they play South. Make sure you wish them good luck. Make sure you wish the girls' tennis team players Allie Brown, Melina McGaw, Azra Radford, Molly Hawker, Cameron Bush, and Grace Deaton as they head to individual districts.
Congrats to boys' cross-country runners Kevin McLean, who placed in the Lee Summit North Invitational, and a huge shout-out to runner Brock Wooderson, who set a new Missouri number one time of 15:23.
The boys' swim and dive team is having an amazing season so far. They swept all 6 teams in their duel last week. The boys had victories from the 200 medley relay of Larry Baldwin, Gabe Marthler, Will Harris, and Caleb Franklin, with victories by diver Josiah Thompson and swimmer Gabe Marthler in the 200 IM and 100 meter breaststroke. Congrats to senior Josiah Thompson, who broke another record, breaking the 11 dive record set in 1987.
The boys football team is looking to bounce back after a tough loss last week to Liberty North. They play Lee Summit North this Friday. Wish them good luck.
That's all we have for this week's sports update. Signing off for Wildcat TV, I'm Sydney Clark.
Next for you, we have Ashlyn speaking about international diversity and some of the students that we have here at Blue Springs.
Hey Wildcats, it's Ashlyn Azura. This year, we're all about equality and diversity. That's why on Wildcat TV, we will be producing a reoccurring diversity segment that will feature second and first generation immigrants that attend Blue Springs High School. This week, we will be featuring Kolvan Zaglasyan, who immigrated here from Syria, and here's his story.
So I'm here now with Kolvan Zaglasyan. So Kolvan, what was the process you went through to get to the U.S., and why did you immigrate to the United States?
I immigrated to the United States because there was a war in Syria and I had to get out. And the process I went through was I got my visa, and then I had to get out of Syria, and I flew to the United States.
So what was the biggest change coming from Syria, and what did you have to adapt to?
The language, I had to learn English. I didn't know any English, and just the culture, everything just moves differently. People just act different, talk different. They just spend their day differently and all that.
Yeah, how long did it take you to perfect the English language, do you think?
I don't know if I have it perfected, but a couple years.
So what is your favorite Syrian food / meal, and explain what it is and what's in it?
I don't really know how to explain what's in it because it's like a bunch of Syrian ingredients, but it's za'atar. It's like that brown seedy stuff that I eat. Just a bunch of seeds and oil.
Do you dip it in bread?
You put it on bread.
On bread? Yeah. Nice. And what holidays do you celebrate differently from the U.S.?
We celebrate Christmas differently. We, in the U.S., kids open their presents on Christmas Day, and we open our presents on New Year's, right when it hits 12 o'clock. And that's about it.
And what is your favorite thing about your culture?
Just how like families are meant to stick together. Like there's not a lot of divorced parents in Syria, unlike the US. And just how family is really close.
All right, thank you. Thank you very much, Hovan.
Thank you, Hovan, for sharing your story. And remember, Wildcats, diversity and acknowledgement of other cultures is important. So don't be afraid to reach out of your comfort zone. I'm Ashlyn DeJuro, signing up for Wildcat TV.
Thanks, Ashlyn. If you happen to see Hovan in the hallways, be sure to say hi to him.
Sydney, did you see that professional NFL player DeAndre Hall was here last week?
Yeah, did you not know that he's a Wildcat alum?
What? No way, that's awesome!
Yeah, he came here because he wanted to inform some of the Wildcats about his new foundation. Delshawn is with the story.
Hey Wildcats, Delshawn Staley, and I'm here with DeAndre Hall, three-time athlete at Blue Springs High School. He played football, basketball, and track, football being his best. He was first team All-State, All-Metro, and won the name of Awesome Money team. So as we walk on this field right now, what are some of the your favorite memories that you have on this field right now?
Besides summer workouts, being out here with the boys was probably my senior year. Beating South here, we Kyle Brown had a punt block, and I was back at punt returner and ended up getting a little scoop and score touchdown, and
yeah,
then getting the game-winning snag over here against South to go up and get a win. That was probably one of the best high school memories I had, man.
Yeah, that's cool. Coming from Blue Springs High School to Northern Iowa to the NFL, like, what was the experience of that? Like, how did it feel going through that?
It was great, man. Northern Iowa really helped shape me going to a smaller school, D1AA, coming from here at Blue Springs. You know, I didn't have too many offers coming out of high school. So with Northern Iowa, getting on that platform and be able to play at a high level was huge. And then NFL, I got drafted by the Chicago Bears in 2016 was, I mean, a blessing. So this is going on to year five now.
Yeah, that's good, that's good. So what, like, what are some words of encouragement that you would like to give kids that want to pursue their dreams and make the dream into a reality?
Keep working and trust the process. Keep God in your life for sure, because at the end of the day, that's what matters, and family.
Yeah, that's good, that's good. So heard that you have a foundation and you want to give back to the community. So like, what is that about?
The foundation is called Hall for One Dream Foundation, here based out of Blue Springs, Kansas City. It's basically geared towards helping out the youth and through sports. And we have an event here coming up, 100 meals over at Autumn's Place Apartments. And we're going to be doing that from 4 to 6. One thing I've always been about is being able to give back. And the best way I can was to open up my own foundation to one, then one day have, you know, my own Boys and Girls Club. And this is kind of the first step. So getting that word out and helping spread word of mouth, getting on things like Wildcat TV is huge, because now you know about it. You didn't know about this yesterday, you know? So it's all a blessing though, man, to be able to spread joy and help out as much as possible. Yeah,
that's good. So, for people to get involved, what should they do?
So I have a website called hallforonedream.org, H-A-L-L-F-O-R, the number one, and then dream.org. And basically what you can do is go on there and check that out. We have a donation tab and we have merch. So what I'm wearing right now is one of two of the t-shirts, Hall for One Dream. And one of the things we really focus on is enrich and encourage the youth. So you can go on there, grab you a t-shirt, or if you didn't want to grab a t-shirt, you can donate. And what the donations are going to go towards are creating a scholarship for student athletes from Blue Springs. So it's one thing we really want to get into. So we gotta keep that coming in, you know. And the t-shirt orders, it's been a blessing now. We're getting them out, but yeah, I mean, check them out.
Very nice.
Black and gray.
Thank you for coming out here and having this chat with me today. And I want you guys to check the link down in the description and check it out. Anything is greatly appreciated. It's Delshawn Slater for Wildcat TV. It's back to the studio.
Wow, what a great foundation he started to give back to our community.
Now, let's send it off to a commercial break. Whoosh!
Hey Wildcats, welcome back to school. This is Brandon Jackley with Chick-fil-A in Blue Springs. We want to show you some amazing things we're doing with our drive-thru. Brooklyn, take it away.
All right, let's go. Here, underneath the big tent, we've got two lanes full of vehicles and we have up to four order takers.
Hi, I'm Emily. And here, when you pull up to the speaker boxes, we're gonna take your payment so the process goes faster.
By the time you get to the window, your food is ready to go.
And the last stop you'll make after you get your food is our condiment station where you can get our famous Chick-fil-A sauce.
Come see for yourself at Chick-fil-A in Blue Springs, across from Home Depot.
Come see us soon.
Hey Wildcats, it's Nev. School is pretty hard right now, whether you're in person or online. That's why Wildcat TV created hashtag WCTVInspire on Twitter. One of the tweets that we loved was, confidence has no competition. We've even had some elementary students say some kind words to us all.
Hi, my name is Izzy Atwood. I'm a fifth grader here at Sunny Point Elementary. My quote is, work hard and be kind. Keep it up, Blue Springs.
Hi, Wildcat TV. I'm Cameron Henderson. I'm a fourth grader at Sunny Point Elementary. And I just wanted to let you know that I know everyone's going through kind of a hard time with the coronavirus. And let your teachers know, and your friends, your parents, your grandparents, that you love them and you appreciate them every single day. And also, I wanted to let you know that you are awesome and you are enough. Thank you.
One of my favorite quotes from the legend himself, Bob Ross, is the imperfections that make something beautiful. That's what makes it different and unique from everything else. And this year is definitely different and unique, and it's not something we expected, but we're gonna make the best out of it. We really wanna bring positivity this school year, so please use this hashtag and it'll be featured in next week's episode. Back to you in the studio.
Welcome back, Wildcats.
Also, don't forget that if you'd like your tweet to be used in an episode, tweet inspiring quotes or thoughts under the hashtag WCTVInspire.
Man, when I was coming into school today, I was late and I tried to go in through the attendance office and I had no clue where that was.
Yeah, me neither. But oh, I think Ash and Riley might know.
Rocky Wildcats, I didn't see you there. Today we are going to be exploring the school to find the elusive office species. Uh-oh, better get a move on.
We ended up wandering the parking lot and as we pierced the baseball field, we spotted it. The attendance office.
Crikey, they must be herd animals, as the new activities office is right there. As we left to search for other offices, we spotted the older brother to the activities office. Once again, we were off. Not too far up the lane, we spotted a wild 300's office. She's a beauty, ain't she? After that, we trekked through the dense forest and in the clearing, we found the admin's office in broad daylight. As the crew went to get lunch, we pierced Bright Boy the counselor's office.
Now remember, Wildcats, these are wild animals. Do not try this at home. I'm Riley Leone, now back to you in the studio.
Thanks, guys. Raven is back with some more information from us at BSSD.
Hey Wildcats! Last week we introduced to you all Us at BSSD.
Now is the week that we start getting active and building a stronger team. There will be a link in the description in today's video if you would like to become a member, where you would need to follow three basic steps. One, your first and your last name. Two, the grade that you are in. And three, a good email that we can get in contact with you. Hope to be hearing from you all.
Thanks, Raven. Be sure to click the link in the description to sign up for Us at BSSD.
You know, I really miss River on the road.
Yeah. And Javon on the lawn.
Ugh, we cannot get rid of these traditions. So what are we gonna do?
Griffin, what are you doing on the ground?
Griffin? On the ground.
Griffin on the ground!
Alright, so it's just a simple question. So what's your favorite part about being back to school?
Friends, I guess. I don't know.
Yeah. You guess?
Yeah.
So out of you three, who's the most likely to like run for presidency?
Oh, me, obviously. Yes.
Why is that?
Because I'm bossy and I like being in charge of people.
Makes sense. He's got my vote. So what's your favorite part about being in high school now?
More freedom.
Yeah. Yeah. Anything that's just completely awful?
The masks.
So how does it feel to be the coolest kid in your family?
I feel like my sister would object, but it feels okay.
Feels okay? Yeah. Are you just like completely better, more funny, better looking, obviously?
Sure.
Just a simple, easy question. If you had a yacht, what would you name it?
Griffin.
That's so sweet. Oh my gosh. Thank you for your time. What celebrity would you like rate a perfect 10?
Summer Rae Count?
I guess, I mean, that's a good answer. I agree. Thank you for your time. If you didn't know my name, what do you think I would look like?
I feel like you'd have like small lips and you have
it's not what I meant.
Your name.
If you didn't know my name, what name would I look like?
You look like Caleb.
A Caleb? Is that like a cute guy name?
No, but in a good way.
Do you think that masks are even useful?
Yeah, because it's still like an airborne like virus or whatever, so I mean, yeah, but like, you know, people don't follow the rules, so that's on them. I think it's effective, and I think it's a good idea.
Good answer. What's the best thing that has been caused from Corona, though?
With quarantine, I got to focus on myself a lot. So self-improvement, self-love for me, and yeah, that was the best part for me.
Love that. Good answer. Thank you very much. We just got done talking to a couple students here, but let's take a break to go see what's happening in an awesome class here at the Freshman Center.
Hi guys, I'm Mrs. Alexander, and today you're going to take a peek at my classroom. We are in the Principles of Biomedical Science class. It's the freshman course, the first course of the Project Lead the Way curriculum. Today they are determining what happens whenever you lie using respiration and heart rate monitors. So they're gripping onto their heart rate monitors, and they're detecting their respiration or breathing rate, and they're going to see if those two factors change if they lie. So they're playing a little game called Two Truths and a Lie, and they're trying to fool their partner. And we're gonna take a look and see if you can actually tell if someone's lying using these two variables. And they're gonna determine if polygraphs, lie detector tests, are actually a valid test to be used in court.
It's fun talking to y'all. It's Griffin. Catch you on the ground.
Don't forget to also tweet under WCTV Inspired to be featured and tag Wildcat TV's Twitter page to vote for further episodes.
That's it for this week's episode.
I'm Aislinn.
And I'm Sydney Wade. And remember,
it's a great day to be a Wildcat.
What are you? You're so aggressive with it. It's a great day to be a Wildcat.
It's a great day.
Oh. I thought you were going to give the other one to someone.